is to adapt a song into a film. I'm taking Ed Sheeran's song Supermarket Flowers. I'm going to convert it into a short film that should be either be put on Netflix or maybe as like part of the BBC thing. The song isn't a single, and there isn't like a music video for it, so I can't get any ideas from that, so it's more original. It's about Ed Sheeran's nan passing away, and I wanted to create that into a film, like to show the journey of their grieving and like show their emotional states. So I didn't want to use Ed Sheeran as the main character, just because I wanted to show like more of a normal family, not a rich family. But this could like affect the fan base, as they would probably want Ed Sheeran to play the main role. I want it to be still a male character though, to show more male emotions, so a female. Just to show like, just to show that their emotions towards the audience and make it more relatable for a male audience, not just female. I won't have many characters in it, just three, the main character, and one other character as a family relative, and the person who died, the man. This is affecting the budget, making it more cheaper to produce. So for the setting, I'm just gonna do it inside of a house, for the dead man. Just for, again, budgeting issues, and make it more like emotional for the person, and the decor on the room will be typically from an old person, to show like the type of person they were when they was alive. And yeah. So the target audience that I want to create is it will be more middle-aged because of the storyline. However, the Ed Sheeran's fan base is quite young, so I feel like their fan base will like bring up to like a younger audience. With like the plot that I'm going for, it would normally reach a female audience. However, I want the male, like for the male character, to bring up more of the male audience. So mostly throughout like the short film, I want to use like close-ups to show like emotion throughout the face, and like long shots to show body language throughout it. And I will be using extreme close-ups like on the eyes to show true emotion through the eyes, of like them like crying or like showing other emotions. So throughout the film, I will be using references from the songs. Like, I'll be using all of these like, as like just to show like different parts of the songs, and with like packed up the photo album that Matthew had made, that's going to be the other character that I'm going to have to show like just like a chain reaction, like by showing like the family and relatives. So my opening scene will be of like a blank space originally, like for about 9 seconds, and like the like original music, the original song will be playing as like the screen is blank, just like to create emotion and tension, and then it will slowly fade into the shot where it's just like an old chair, and the main character will slowly walk and sit into the chair. There'll be a close-up of the person, like, just looking sad, and, like, a little bit lingering, just to show, like, they're like, having a moment, sat in the chair, if you know what I mean. And then the Matthew character will call them out from the chair, and they'll just walk off, but the camera will still linger and, like, focus on the chair to show that the chair has meaning, or it, like, resembles the person who died. So for the rest of the story, to like bulk it up a bit, like show about what happened to the dead person. I'm going to like have the main character like go through that house, clean it over. That's about what the song is about. And like look at objects or like go through photo albums, and like, this could like go into like flashbacks or like, and these like have like a hazy like thing over them, so you can tell the difference between the flashbacks and like real life. And this will show like the relationship that the main character had with their nan. For the soundtrack, I'm going to be using the original song but without the lyrics, because I feel like the soundtrack would be like more emotional. But I'm not going to use it throughout the whole thing, otherwise it would be like a bit annoying and a bit samey. So I'm going to use other sad songs. But for like the flashbacks, as they are going to be more like of a happy scene, I will use happy music throughout that. Yeah, that's it. Any questions? Any questions?
Did you say what age range would be
for? It's either going to be between like 15 and like 40 something, so it's like going to be quite wide, due to like the story and like Ed Sheeran's fan base.
Where are you going to see it then, Jenna? Where's it going to play out?
I was thinking either like maybe on Netflix, or maybe it can be on BBC for advertising, because I don't want advertising show throughout it. I just want it like continuous for emotional effect.
So where's the funding coming from then, if you're not advertising that? I mean, it's supported by advertising.
I'm not sure.
I think, okay, yeah, how would you do that? Definitely. I mean, if it's something like, I don't know, you know, kind of, how would it fit into BBC remit of public service broadcasting, that kind of thing? Mm-hmm. Unless you were going to use it on the back of tackling a social issue, you think you touched on something quite current there in terms of male emotion. One of the current topic,
yeah,
is the fact that that there's a high proportion of men vis-a-vis women,
yeah,
with mental health,
yeah,
issues, because it's, you know, harder for the,
yeah,
men stereotypically. So, mm-hmm, you could do it in that kind of context there.
Yeah.
I thought you had some really nice detail in your storyboard about how visually it was going to look. Make sure that actually comes through in your storyboarding.
Yeah,
together.
Yeah.
So you talked about flashbacks and so on,
mm-hmm,
and filters, hazy things. You,
yeah,
mean filters,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah.
When you said hazy things. And when you were talking about the room, shush a minute please. When you're talking about the room, you did talk nicely about what the room was going to look like. So make sure that comes through in your mise-en-scene,
mm-hmm,
that how you're going to construct,
yeah,
that sense of this person's kind of lived there and it's their space and their signifier of the chair and so on and so forth. So I did think you had quite a lot of nice information in there. Again, you know, think about your working title, think about a tagline, think about who's going to play your characters and all of that,
yeah,
detail to flesh it out.
I was going to have the title as like the song title, Supermarket Flowers, and I was going to have like a slogan saying "Wait for me to come home," because it's like,
okay.